Hi guys, welcome back to WebJada. In the previous one, we used store files to store all our variables in a single file, which can be accessible by all the components, right? But for now, we have only one component. We'll try to create multiple components out of it. So I'm gonna do the simplest one here, which is the message. So I'm gonna remove that and put it into a component. I'll call this card length or something dot salt. Now I'll have the same message here, and I'll have a script. I will have to import these files, whichever is necessary for us. In this case, we only want card and we don't want products or address. So once we have that in place of what we, you know, where we had that message, we can actually have cart length. This way. Now, cart length is not imported, so I'll just import it. Dot slash cart length dot swelt. Now that should take care of it. So it says zero items. When I add, it still works, right? So because it is getting the same data as this component. Now, so this is a component now. So this is mode. Let's move the products, right? So basically products is this each loop and loops through this dollar products. I'll just move that to a new component called products. That should be enough. We'll just have it here. Now we need dollar products for that, so we'll have to get that. We'll use the same thing. You can just copy paste, but in this case we only want products, not the cart or the address. Now that is done, but we need a function as well, because on click it goes to, you know, it calls add to cart. That is not there, so we'll find where add to cart is. This is where it is. I will get that in the script, but for that function to run, we need cart, so we'll just have cart here again. That should take care of it. Is there anything missing? Product link. Okay, the styles. So we can move the styles as well. Whatever is necessary for our product list. One is product list, another one is image. So I'll just move this. For now, I'll copy it and then move it. Okay, so cart item is not required. Product list is enough. And now that is in the home page. Yeah. So here we don't need a product list here. We don't need image, because these are already moved. Okay, so once that is done, we have to check, we have to actually have it here in place of product. We have to get that. We'll just copy it. We'll have products. Okay, so we are not importing it. We'll do that as well. Okay, so we have the product here, so with all the details properly, even with the styles. So that reduced our code a lot, and it still works as expected. Now, maybe this is the last thing, I hope. Cart. We'll move cart to a component called cart. It should be fine. We'll paste this here, but you know that by now, you must already know that we need cart. How do we get it? We get it from here. So here what I see is cart is the only thing we need. So we can just get that out. And total. So total is calculated this way. So we'll just remove that from there. And have it here. Okay, so that should do it. What else is there? minus item and plus item. Okay, so these functions are also from the cart, so we'll just have them here. So I'll just make a space here. Okay, maybe I should keep total at the bottom just so that we can differentiate, because total is usually at the bottom. Okay, so that is done. So this is unused CSS error, so we can just go back here and see the styles. So there's this cart item, total, cart list, which is not required. Now that should have taken care of it, but we don't have cart imported here. So where is our products here? I'll just paste it. We'll have cart, and then copy paste the same thing. I'll have cart here and then cart here. Okay, so we should have cart. I don't know if it is why isn't it getting the style. Okay, so we removed it, but we removed the style, but we did not apply it here. Let's go back. Okay, yeah, we have the cart as it was before. So let's add items. So increment, decrement, and then removing also happens. Good. So we have that there. The only thing that is left is address. We'll move that to our address component. Until here, we'll have a component called address. I really like how Svelte, you know, in Svelte, one file is a component, which is not the case in React or in other, maybe in Vue it is the same, I don't know, but this is good, this is fantastic actually. Okay, so we need address, right? So we are using $address that is imported through this. Okay, we don't need any of that, I think, or do we? Okay, we need checkout script though, but checkout will need all that. Okay, going here, checkout, address and cart. Okay, going back here and add that there. Cart, address, products is not required. Okay, yeah, let's hope this works as usual. We will add that here. As I'm kind of doing it in reverse, because I should have imported first. That's all right. Okay, so yeah, let's see if this works as usual. Yes, all these fields are working. Checkout is working as well. Good. So we can all right, so we had a very long file, the app file, but now it is reduced to like 15, maybe, you know, maximum of 15 lines. And now it becomes easy to, you know, go to a, you know, when there is something wrong or you want to change something, you can go to a particular component and change it. So yeah, I think I'll just move this to the last. That's the that's how it is done usually. Okay, yeah, anyway, so yeah, that's it guys. So this is how you can make components and make sure they share the same data throughout. So I'll just check whether it works properly. I'll just remove orange, just add again, and I'll add some message. And yeah, so our alert shows. Yep, so everything is working perfect. So that's it for this one. Thanks guys, bye bye.